If you want to animate a circle just like this one, in this After Effects tutorial, I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to get it done. First step is we just want to make a new composition. I'm going to go to composition, new composition. I'm just going to set it to the preset that I have here. I'm just going to name it. Press enter. Here is my composition. I'm just going to fit it to my window. And the first thing I want to do is create the shape. So I'm going to come up here. I'm going to make sure ellipse tool is selected. And while holding shift in the center of my frame, I'm just going to draw it. The only reason I'm holding shift here is because if I don't hold shift, it's gonna give me an ellipse instead of a circle. So I'm just gonna delete that. And now we have a layer down here, shape layer one. I'm just gonna press that layer, press enter to rename it. And then I'm gonna press the V tool to get my selection tool. I'm just gonna move this somewhere in the center here. If your circle is filled when you created it, you could come up here to fill, select the text itself, and just press no fill. If you have fill select, it's gonna fill it with a color. So we don't want that here. We just want it to be transparent. So I'm gonna press none, press okay. And the fill color here, we don't care about because we don't have any fill inside. The stroke though, we care about. We wanna change how thick the stroke is. So I'm gonna change it to 30. And I'm gonna change the stroke color here to red. So I'll just pick red here, press okay. So now we have a red 30 pixel stroke. That's layer one here. And now to animate this layer, we wanna go to our effects and preset. And I wanna search for radial wipe. That's the transition radial wipe here. I'm gonna grab that and apply it to my layer. And it's applied here to the layer. Now we need to animate that transition that we just applied. So I'm going to go up here and under transitional completion, I'm going to turn on my clock here to start keyframe. And in the beginning, I want it to be transitional completion at 100. That'll make it blank. Then I'll move to 1 second on my timeline and then make the transitional completion back to 0%. Press enter. So now if we go to our timeline, if I press spacebar and press play, our transitional completion starts with 0 and then it goes to 100. Now, if you want this to be built the other way, you could go up here under wipe and change it to counterclockwise. Now it's gonna build it the other way. So if you want it clockwise, it goes that way. If you want it counterclockwise, change it the other way. Now you have an animated circle. At this point, if you want to change the shape of your layer, you could do that. You could just grab it and change the layer. If you don't want a perfect circle, you could change it to any shape you want. And the transition is gonna still apply. I'm gonna just Command Z to undo that. I'll show you one more quick thing here that could come in handy. You could put another thinner circle inside this one and make a cooler effect here. So I'm gonna select this layer. And I'm gonna Command D to duplicate it. And now I have a new circle here. I'm gonna name this one circle green. And now if I take this one and I change the stroke to green, and I'll change the pixel density to 15. There we go. And now I'm gonna put it underneath the other layer by grabbing it and putting it under. So you see the red layer first. And now I need to offset my keyframes between the two layers. So I'm gonna press U. That'll show the keyframes for both of my layers. Now if I offset this one here, you see it's created a circle inside the other circle. So you see the green one going first and then the red one is going second. So it creates a cool effect. If I bring it even further back, it creates a really interesting effect here. So you could do this with multiple layers, multiple colors, and really bring this animated circle to life. Now I could just go to my 3 second mark, press N, that's my out point for the layer, and then I could export, add to render queue, and to make sure the transparency still is intact, I'm gonna change the channel from RGB to RGB plus alpha. That'll make sure the transparency behind my circle is there. I'm gonna press OK, and then I could just render this out to use it on top of any video file.